Hello.
I am your art buddy Scuppy, and I am so happy to see you again. Today, we will see how to draw three different kinds of rosebuds very easily. Alright, let's draw the first rosebud. This one is so easy. Begin by drawing a slanted U shape with almost a closed mouth. Then draw a small curvy line from the top right of the U shape side, and then a bigger line from the top left side. And then join the top. That's it. Easy, wasn't it? I've used a green marker pen for making the leaves and the stem. I've made four leaves, two on the left and two on the right. Try to keep the leaves curvy to give them a natural look. If you want, you can draw with a pencil and then trace it with the green marker pen. Rose is the most popular flower in the world. For the stem, I drew small slanted lines with a dark green marker to give it a thorny look. I have used lighter shades of green and red to fill the rosebud and the stem, and I have used darker shades of these colors to give it some shading. There are over 100 different types of roses. Each one of us has it in themselves to be a free spirit, just as every rosebud has in it a rose. I have made smaller strokes with the darker shades to give the shading effect. Wow, doesn't it look pretty? I bet you found it easy too. By the way, if you want to learn how to draw a rose easily, the link is up there right now. I have also posted it in the description below. Alright, let's draw the second rosebud. I love spirals, so I will draw a spiral. We will end the spiral as if you were writing the number 7. I am drawing a curvy line from the other side. I am drawing very slow so that you can easily follow along. If you face any difficulty or have questions, please reach out to me by writing in the comments below. I have tried to keep it very easy for you. I used a black marker pen for the outline and dark green pen for stem and leaves. Draw two straight lines for the stem, and then some slanted lines to draw the thorns. Wavy lines work well for the leaves. Did you know that bud and leaves are organic shapes? You can experiment with the size of leaves and buds. Change the curves and it will look all natural. So don't worry if your leaves show up to me smaller or bigger. They will all look natural. Just believe in yourself and progress with your work. I then drew a spiral inside the existing spiral with a darker red marker to give shading effect. I also used this darker red to give some shading effects in the bud. After you're done with shading, you can use a white pencil or glitter for the highlights. And we are done with the second rose. Yay! You are now a temp. Let's look at the last rosebud we will draw today. Draw a slanted spiral, just like our galaxy. All you need to do is draw the spiral and then some S-shaped curvy lines. This bud is a little slimmer with a small mouth at the top. You can experiment with the size of this bud based on your requirement. If you are making a greeting card for your mom or your dad, or if you are drawing this on a gift tag, you can change the sizes of these buds to suit your needs. You can experiment with the color that you use in the rosebuds. You can use colors like yellow, pink, purple, or whatever color you like. Today, we saw three different types of rosebuds. Let me know in the comments if you drew them. I enjoyed working with you today and will see you in the next video. Sayonara!